fortune brings you back to me, Jonathan. What is it, my dear?
I'm afraid it's bad news, Elizabeth. The worst, actually.
Please, speak up.
Edgar is no longer in McCullum's grasp. I resolved that matter.
Where is our good friend now? Is he well?
He was mortally wounded. I put an end to his misery.
That is terrible, Jonathan. And yet you did what you must. The poor man.
Edgar Swansea was responsible for the Skull epidemic, Elizabeth. It was he who unleashed the deadly scourge upon London.
What? Are you certain? This is the most terrible accusation of all.
He confessed everything to me. He sought to cure the disease, to exploit vampire blood to stop the epidemic. But he unwittingly gave birth to a catastrophe.
All those poor victims. How could he do it? What happened?
Edgar was a criminal. He abused every ethical tenet to test his theory about vampire blood as a cure for influenza.
I must say, I'm shocked, Jonathan. Who would have thought it? And the poor patient. Let me guess. It was Harriet Jones, was it not?
Yes. That explains how Doris Fletcher was infected and how she became an ICOR. She secretly visited her mother at Pembroke.
Then we have no choice. We must act quickly, Jonathan. We must return to the sewers and put an end to the threat poor Harriet embodies.
I have one more matter to discuss with you. Harriet Jones was the primary case, but do you know what a healthy carrier is?
There is a tone in your voice that frightens me, Jonathan. What are you trying to say?
It was your blood Edgar used for his experiment on Harriet Jones.
What? No. No. This can't be. Oh.
Elizabeth. Are you all right?
No, I have to go.
What do you mean?
Leave me alone. Save the city, Jonathan. Save what can be saved.
Elizabeth, I need answers. Why did your blood
cause
this?
Stay away from me. Please. I swear I never was your
enemy. Wait. No. Elizabeth. Now would be a good time to blend the recipe Marshall used when he fought the disaster. I think I know where to find what I need.
I'll kill
Whose blood could be pure?
Good evening.
Have you any... You need some rest. Good evening, Ulch.
I won't...
You were one of them, Johnny. Why was I so blind?
Have you any...
I
may have a...
Between men and women! Women's right to vote is...
Good evening, Doctor.
May be the most disappointing dish I have ever tasted. So insipid, so cold.
Sir, you are not welcome here.
Good evening, Miss Ashbury.
And
what is your...
It's...
Goodbye. Good evening, Miss
Ashbury. And...
Find my killer. Betrayer.
You are not welcome.
Don't.
I'm still persona non grata in the Ascalon clan. I want to speak regularly.
Good evening, Lord Redgrave.
What are you doing here, traitor? I shall smite you for this audacity.
I'm not here to bicker, Lord Redgrave. I can put an end to this epidemic, but I need your assistance to do so.
Good. We've held out thus far, but the time has come to put an end to this crisis. Tell me, what do you need?
The blood of William Marshall.
The blood of William Marshall? Of my maker? Are you mad? This blood is the purest of all. My maker proffered it to me on the battlefield. I cannot hand it to you.
This is more important than the club, you or me. This is London's last hope.
I see. Well, in that case, given the gravity of the situation, I suppose I can spare you a drop.
Thank you, my lord.
If you manage to save this city, you'll prove yourself a veritable servant of the crown. So godspeed, Dr. Reid. Our fate lies wholly in your hands.
Thank you. This is no place for you, sir. I said go back home!
I cannot use garlic, but there may be a substitute in the Pembroke Hospital drug storage. It's locked, all right.
I'll send you for-
There it is. Insulin. Much more efficient than garlic against blood poisoning and sepsis, and much less dangerous for me. Thank you, Dr. Polescu. If McCullum really drank the blood of King Arthur, then I may have found another vital ingredient for my recipe.
You listening? Get them weapons!
Filthy murdering bastard!
Defender of this land will protect you. True light will cleanse you.
Good evening, vampire hunter.
Are you here to mock me, Reid?
Not at all, McCullum. I am here because I need you.
Really? I'm intrigued. Speak up, then.
I need the blood of a king. The blood of Arthur. I'm certain you possess it, and I must have it.
The guard's most sacred and precious relic. Why would you... You found Marshall's memoirs. I should have destroyed that book.
I need the antidote to save this city, McCullum.
It is within me to take your words as truth. I want to. But I must know more. What precisely are your plans?
A creature called a disaster is about to be unleashed. It falls upon me, as once it did Marshall, to stop it before the whole country is ravaged.
I should have destroyed that book. And yet, I wish I could join this battle alongside you. But this crusade is not mine to fight.
Do you not understand? We wanted the same thing from the outset. A means to end this vampire epidemic.
Not enemies. Maybe that is so. Take it then. I see no other hope for this city. If this is some trick, you will be damned, Dr. Reid.
Thank you. And farewell, McCullum.
Unbelievable as it is, I wish you good luck, Reid.
The blend seems stable. Time to go and find Harriet in the sewers.